Every time I drive home from work, I don't remember the drive. Like, I don't at all. What the hell is going on? Am I losing my mind? Hey guys, Julie here for DNews. I'm not losing my mind, my mind is just going on autopilot. I know you're just sitting there, but right now your brain is buzzing a million miles an hour. And doing the same thing every day, like brushing your teeth, driving to work, your brain just kind of runs on autopilot. Our brains like routines, we like familiar things, and a lot of routines wind up becoming part of that autopilot mode. So how does that happen? How does your brain just turn into a zombie? Well, there's a lot going on when you switch from autopilot to on mode, and different parts of your brain control these different modes. Let's look at two main brain regions in this process. When your brain's just on zombie mode, when you're, say, in an elevator on your way to work and you haven't had any coffee yet, your dorsal lateral striatum pushes the third floor button automatically for you. But when you're in a different situation, like on vacation in Hawaii on your way to go snorkeling, your dorsal medial striatum hits the lobby button. Studies like one published in the journal Neuron show that these two areas of the brain work in tandem when learning a new task and turning it into a habit. When researchers looked at the activity of neurons in rats learning to navigate a maze, they found that the dorsal lateral striatal neurons were particularly active at certain points in the maze, mostly whenever an action had to be performed, like stopping or turning, which makes sense since these neurons play a part in movement. The researchers found that these neurons' activity increased as the rats got better at the maze and sort of leveled off after a while. While on the other hand, activity in the dorsal medial striatum, a part of the brain responsible for higher level thinking, decreased as the rats got better. Basically, the better they learned the maze, the less they had to think about it. So the maze sort of becomes like muscle memory. And a study published in the journal Nature Communications found that a third region of the brain, the orbital frontal cortex, shifts the gears between these two modes. And those aren't the only areas of the brain that helps you get a routine down. In one study, published in the journal Neuron, researchers found that the rostrolateral prefrontal cortex, an area of neurons situated in the front of your brain, keeps you on task while you learn a routine. The researchers found that if they stimulated this part of the brain while study participants were focused on a task, they would make more mistakes. The researchers found using fMRI techniques that activity in this part of the brain goes up and down as a participant works their way through a series of tasks. They think this is due to some uncertainty they face as they make a choice. Apparently, this part of the brain helps resolve some of that uncertainty. So after we've learned a task, it becomes routine and there's no uncertainty. Another study showed that once you've learned something, since there's no more uncertainty, you're not making any decisions anymore. You basically do the same thing based on a decision you made many times before, like the left turn right before your house. And researchers think this helps to conserve cognitive resources. So when you're running on autopilot, basically your brain hates thinking and wants to do as little of it as possible to save energy. So hurry up and make things routine. Your brain needs to rest. Want to get someone else on a routine? Maybe one day we could change someone's behavior just by flipping a switch or, well, reprogramming a few neurons. To learn more about that, check out this video right here.
Now, however, it's been shown that knowing exactly how behavior flows through the brain means we can direct that flow. If we have a complete map of a human brain, think of the implications. Maybe we can write out behavioral disorders like ADHD.
So what sort of things do you do just on autopilot? Is it like your drive home from school, brushing your teeth in the morning? Let me know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.